prior to my stroke, I had worked for most of my professional life in biomedical science, with a special emphasis, special interest in microbiology. I'd worked for the NHS, and I'd worked in higher education institutions teaching medical microbiology. And this still remains an interest and a passion of mine, although I'm hopelessly out of date, but I do still do a little reading. When I suffered the stroke, I was actually working for, no longer in a laboratory situation, I was working for the British Council, and my role was to advise overseas directors on health projects that they might undertake in the countries in which they served, and also advising overseas students on where to study health-related topics in the UK. That was my role. Following my stroke, I had to change my ideas about retirement, because I had intended to get back and work voluntarily, if necessary, in laboratories again, to get back to my great interests. But I would now be a hazard in a laboratory with the limitations imposed by my stroke, so that was really out. Instead, I developed this new career, and it's interesting thinking back how this came about. And the first step, and I think this is important for everyone, my story obviously is entirely personal, and people will develop themselves and their interests differently. But I became involved in other things by first volunteering. And I worked as a volunteer for an organisation in Liverpool that is concerned with the survival and life of people post a neurological crisis, such as a stroke. And as a result of this, I was aware of what was going on, for example, within the NHS, and especially within healthcare locally. And from there, I obtained a part-time job. I became employed again by the NHS in a very different capacity. But I had a part-time appointment post-stroke. And this arose as a result of my involvement in a voluntary capacity. So that's a good tip for people. There are plenty of voluntary opportunities if you care to look for them, and it can lead to all sorts of things. So that was how I got into this, and then subsequently, once you are known to have an interest in areas where you're actually contributing your time and energy freely, it's remarkable how many offers you will get. So it just grew and grew until really I was in a situation where I rarely had a day off in the week, and maybe that was too much, but it proves, I guess, that there are opportunities out there, and probably more than one can cope with.